Guy Dill has been a part of the Venice landscape for over 40 years. He is one of the acknowledged contemporary masters of large-scale abstract sculptural works.
We're very privileged to have one of your pieces of art here right behind us. Tell us about this piece of art and what it represents.
Yeah, this is sort of my counter in the restaurant, and I change the work on occasion, and it's a nice thing to have work in the community that I can go and have lunch next to. You know, it's an interesting feeling. This work is titled Mahout. Mahout is an elephant driver. I spent a little bit of time in India, not a real long time, but you know, you can spend 10 days there and it rubs off. All of the imagery I saw in the Middle East and in India really kind of got into my head and made it a little more liquid. The form started to change. And there's a direct bearing on what I did when maybe 6 months or a year after I got back. And Mahout is in that series.
Okay, in the 40 years that you've been in the area, how has it changed the essence of the free spirit from 40 years ago to now?
You know, Venice was warehouses and oil wells, oil rigs.
Yep, industrial.
You could look anywhere, and that was the motion of what was going on, pulling oil out of the ground. And it was an ideal place for artists. And initially, you could move around. Rent was cheap, but you know, once the artists go someplace, it's not long after that developers and people of money follow, because it becomes, they see it's a livable area.
What about food, say 40 years ago, the area to now? I mean, how's it changed?
Well, you know, interestingly, we're in Hal's restaurant.
Yes.
Hal had the first restaurant in Venice. There were no restaurants. There was one, and it was on the boardwalk, and they served a great pepper steak, and if you could get the money together to eat that, otherwise you bought your food at a market and cooked it at home. I mean, you know, when you don't have any money, it's not a hardship, it's just you got to find other ways to eat. There was basically nothing, but what came in first, interestingly, the restaurants really began with Bruce Martyr and Michael McCarty with the new California cuisine, which was a lighter French fare. I hope I do it justice by calling it that. I think that's the way it's phrased. And West Beach opened up. And West Beach was one of the first restaurants in LA to actually show art by artists on the walls that were exhibitions. And you got a few free meals for that when you
put
up a show.
Which is now James Beach.
Which is now James Beach, yeah. Essentially the same, they hang art. Yep. But restaurants in LA started showing art as a result of the Venice restaurant that opened.
And speaking of art, some say that Jody Maroni's sausage is a work of art.
Greetings to you. How are you guys doing?
Good. He's very shy. He hates the publicity, but he makes the world's greatest sausage. What makes your sausages so great?
Dedication, but also the best product, what goes into it. It has a reputation. It's a little bit of a voodoo food people don't want to touch. So we make them as coarse as we can so you can see what's in there. Also, just we reinterpret a lot of gourmet dishes and make them into sausages. What makes a sausage great is when you get it served to you, it's boiling in the middle and crisp on the outside. And when you bite into it, it floods you with flavor.
And you've got a great range of sausages. Tell us about some of those sausages.
We have chicken with pomegranate. We have chicken with apple. Hot Italian with oranges and Parmesan. We make a Danziger sausage. We make Toulouse garlic sausage.
So,
a lot of sausage.
Well, you've got the whole world. You've got Italian, you've got French, and you have the giant Kobe dog.
The giant Kobe dog. And why giant Kobe? Because Kobe beef is the richest beef in the world, and we want to make the biggest, tastiest hot dog.
So it really is about size, isn't it? It's not the...
In the case of the Kobe, it's about size, and in the case of everything else, it's about quality.
Well, let's see your Kobe dog. Let's see how big it is.
Check this out.
This is absolutely huge.
Check out the Kobe dog. Giant, 1/3 pound, and look at how it makes you feel.
And what does it taste like?
Mm.
Can I have a bite? Give me a bite. Very nice, isn't it?
Very nice.
Okay. If somebody wants to know more about where they can get the best sausage from,
Jody Maroni.
And right here at the Venice
Beach
Boardwalk.
And right here at Venice Boardwalk. Come on down, we'll find you.
Jody, thank you very much.
Thank you,
man. Cheers. It's very nice.
And if you can't get to a Jody Maroni restaurant, then keep your eye out for the Jody Maroni food truck. This looks delicious. Yum! And coming up next, we'll go into Hell's Kitchen.